I titled this report as Tesla Future because once this battery that I'm about to tell you is in production, I don't see any reason Tesla won't buy them and use them in its vehicles, just like Tesla buys batteries for its cars from CATL, Panasonic, LG Energy, and so on. So there is new battery by a startup company. This new 621 mile range electric vehicle battery charges in 6 minutes and works in any weather. The battery charges in the time it takes to fill a car with gasoline. So do you see Tesla using this one day and getting at this range level with its electric cars? Welcome back, everyone. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment and subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle breaking news. Chinese startup Greater Bay Technology has claimed that its new electric vehicle battery can work in any weather. Called the Phoenix Cell, the battery uses superconducting materials and thermal management to bring freezing temperatures to normal room temperatures in just 5 minutes. Bloomberg reported this news. Extreme temperatures have been the bane for batteries of electric vehicles since they were introduced. As the temperature dips below 32 degrees Fahrenheit, that's 0 degrees Celsius, electric vehicle batteries lose their charging efficiency, making it difficult for owners to rely on the range offered by the cars. Car makers have turned to installing heat pumps to keep battery temperatures in a high efficiency range, but that too is an inefficient way to manage the battery of your electric vehicle. Founded in 2020, this Greater Bay Technology company is looking to radically change how electric vehicle batteries operate, and with its Phoenix Cell claims to have tackled major headache for electric vehicle makers. So who is behind Greater Bay Technology? Let's see how serious this thing is. Greater Bay Technology was founded by Huang Hyang-dong along with industry veteran Pei Feng in 2020. Huang and Pei were colleagues at GAC, the third most popular electric vehicle brand in China after BYD and Tesla. Huang studied automotive engineering in Italy in the 1980s and worked as a postdoctoral researcher at Fiat's research center for 5 years before returning to China in 1991. From 2006, Huang led the R&D center at GAC, where he oversaw the development of GS4 SUV, one of the company's most popular models. Huang retired in 2016, but returned in 2020 to bring in battery technology that can make electric vehicles as easy to own and operate as gasoline-powered cars. Their first-generation battery can recharge in about 15 minutes and can deliver a range of 310 miles. The technology is already being implemented in GAC's Aeon and electric SUV, the Bloomberg report that said. Now let me tell you a little bit about this Phoenix battery cell. The next generation Phoenix cell can deliver a range of 621 miles, that's 1000 kilometers, friends, on a single charge. According to Huang, the use of superconducting materials and thermal management technology in the cell ensures that the battery can be heated back from temperatures as low as minus 4 Fahrenheit, that's minus 20 degrees Celsius, to 77 Fahrenheit, which is 25 degrees Celsius, in just 5 minutes. Now that the battery is within its normal operating temperature range, it can be rapidly charged and reach full capacity in just 6 minutes. Effectively, the cell can be used in any weather conditions and is equivalent to filling the tank of a gasoline-powered car, matching the company's vision. The Phoenix battery not only addresses the long charging time for electric vehicles, but other pain points. It doesn't matter if it's a hot day or cold day, the Phoenix battery's range will not be affected. Huang is confident that his technology will increase the mass adoption of electric vehicles. The Phoenix cell could be seen in action as early as next year on GAC's Aeon EV, as well as electric vehicles of other car makers. I think Tesla will use it. So in just 2 years, Greater Bay Technology has become a unicorn company valued at $1 billion and finds itself mentioned along with battery bigwigs like Contemporary Amperes Technology Limited and BYD in China. Contemporary Amperes Limited is CATL, which is the main battery provider for Tesla. So, like I said, do you believe maybe within 1 or 2 years, once this battery, Phoenix battery cell, which charges in 6 minutes, that's the time it takes to charge a gasoline car, is in production, Tesla will use them, and maybe starting next year or the following year, we should start seeing the average range of electric vehicles per single charge in the range of 600 miles. I think this is coming within a year. How many years do you think it will take for electric vehicles to be in the range of 621 miles, which is 1,000 kilometers per single charge? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below and like this video if you found it helpful. Morgan Stanley says Tesla vehicle sales process is a competitive advantage. The conclusion came after an analyst bought a car for a traditional dealer, actually from a traditional dealer, and his experience was filled with negativity. Morgan Stanley analyst Adam Jonas spoke about his recent experience buying a new car. This prompted him to point out the advantages Tesla has in owning its own stores. Tesla's sales model works for consumers, for car buyers, while traditional dealers are only looking for ways to ensure their own interests are served. Jonas said that for the purchase, he chose a car that was in short supply. So he had to look at several dealers before settling on one. All dealers considered were charging above MSRP, but the analyst managed to find one who promised to sell at MSRP. However, having come to the place, the seller then gave price higher than promised. Jonas shared his experience. This is through via Sawyer Merritt Twitter. So he said, I was greeted by a friendly sales professional who took me upstairs to a prep garage where he pointed to the brand new SUV. So here's your new truck. I turned to him and said, isn't she beautiful? Hey, I just wanted to confirm that there is no dealer adjustments on this vehicle. He looked at me and said, you gotta be kidding. This model is in super short supply. We ask for thousands above MSRP in this market. Exacerbated, I said, but I called and confirmed with your coordinator you were asking for MSRP before driving down here. To which he responded, who told you that? No way I'd normally start someone at least $3,000 above sticker on this vehicle. You should do your research, buddy. So as you can see, this is not a pleasant situation, right? Jonas says, so I took a deep breath and said very slowly, you know, I thought this might be a problem, and handed him my phone with the screenshot clearly showing the dealer price equals MSRP for this exact stock number. He looked down at the phone and with a straight face said, okay, then I guess that's the price. I asked him, look, I get it. You're just doing your job, but is this how the process really works? Now, friends, while Jonas did manage to buy his chosen car at MSRP, it was a hassle for him. The negative experience he had with the purchase led him to point out the benefits of Tesla's direct sale model. In fact, the company works for consumers, for car buyers, offering the same prices to everyone who is in the region where the store is located. According to Jonas, this is a competitive advantage for a manufacturer, in this case for Tesla. He says, Tesla's sales process is a competitive advantage. While a lot of attention this year has been paid to Tesla's frequently changing prices within one region, all car buyers pay the same price for the vehicle. There is no haggling, no arbitrage between stores. It's a smooth process that is creating an increasingly visible discrepancy between the legacy car buyers and experience and the Tesla experience, he wrote. What do you think, friends? Do you like buying from directly from the company or through a dealer? What are the benefits of buying directly from Tesla or buying directly from a dealer? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I'll see you soon in our next report.